Hi, my name is Mekena Metcalf, and I am a research scientist at Berkeley Lab, working in the Applied Mathematics and Computational Research Division. Today, I want to talk to you a little bit about what is the difference between quantum information science and all of these other new computational science efforts that I hear about. So in our world, we're faced with a lot of different problems, and we want to be able to find solutions to these problems. So an example of a problem that maybe humanity faces is, why isn't my Amazon package getting here on time? And so what we do is we want to be able to create models to be able to see, why isn't my Amazon package getting here on time? And this particular problem is called the traveling salesman problem, and it's a classic optimization algorithm that we put together and we want to be able to solve on really big computers. So one of the issues when we think about simulation of optimization problems or chemistry is we put together models that describe our problem, and then we can simulate those models on classical computers. But the more accurate of a solution that we want, or the accurate of a prediction, the more complicated our model becomes, and bigger a computer we need to be able to solve it. So another thing that we can do is look at artificial intelligence or machine learning algorithms. Now, these are powered by data coming from the real world. And these neural networks that underlie a lot of these machine learning algorithms build its own models based on the data coming in through training. But it requires massive amounts of data to be able to make predictions. So this is one of the challenges, for instance, with having self-driving cars. But if we think about quantum computing and how it's different than classical computing, well, first, as Monica said, the fundamental information unit that we use for classical computing based on bits of zero and one is fundamentally different than how we think about quantum computing. And so the difference is like the difference between a baseball and an atom. They're very different. Next. So if we think about how atoms behave, they behave very differently than the things that we interact with in our everyday lives. Because in fact, they behave as waves, and they're able to spread themselves out over space and time. But what's really cool is if I have two atoms, and they're described by two different wave functions. And what happens is the wave functions of these atoms interfere in such a way that they become correlated. And this is what we call entanglement. But there's a little bit more. This isn't like any wave like in the ocean, right? It has a little extra property. And this is what happens if I were to look at the atoms and measure them. What happens is they collapse their wave functions. And now that we've looked at them, we know exactly where they are. So what is quantum computing all about? Yes, we're trying to use the properties of atoms, like these wave functions, to be able to solve really hard problems that I spoke about before. For instance, that traveling salesman problem is a very classic problem that we want to be able to use quantum computers how to solve. And so a quantum algorithm designer like myself essentially is trying to find interference patterns that power quantum technologies to solve these hard problems. And as I mentioned, these quantum computers, they're good at solving certain types of models. So optimization, and another one is chemistry. So we have models that actually are able to capture the properties of molecules or electrons in molecules. And these models are actually really hard to solve and require massive computers to be able to get accurate answers. But we can actually encode these models of electrons onto quantum computers with the hopes of extracting more accurate and even be able to solve bigger molecules on these quantum computers. And I'd like to talk about a little bit different, where it all starts to come together. You know, as Monica mentioned earlier, we have quantum computing, we have quantum sensing, we have quantum networking. So like, what could we envision a future quantum information science ecosystem looking like? And we can imagine in the future, we have these quantum sensors that are able to extract quantum data from some experiment, and it wants to send this quantum data through a network and to a quantum computer to be able to be processed. This is similar to how these machine learning algorithms are done. And if we're able to have new probes of nature, as well as new powerful computing power, we could really unlock further secrets of the universe. So, you know, what I want to get across is quantum information science is really different than how we think about classical computing. Yeah, we have certain models, and the models we want to be able to solve on classical computers and quantum computers are very similar, but fundamentally the underlying mechanisms are completely different. And I feel that quantum information science is going to be a paradigm shift in quantum computing and usher in a new age of information. Thank you.